Guys, today I'm going to show you how I use my brand new Call Me Fantastic eyeliner. This is our waterproof pencil that I feel like all our products, we really take 2 to 3 years to develop because there's so much of research that goes into it. It's also just finding the right kind of product that really works for my clients and for myself, obviously. So this one is a waterproof liner and it's a pencil and it lasts all day, all night. Now, with a lot of pencils in the market, it was really hard to find something that was really dark, but also the ingredients were super clean. This is vegan. This is clean on your eyes. Plus, someone like me, I have very, very sensitive skin, eyes. It's like, I almost feel like this brand, I created it for people who are exactly like me, who have issues with so many different things. And, you know, things happen to me so that I can be able to create products for all of us. I think that's what happens, like acne or like styes or whatever possible. So anyways, I'm going to show you how I use my Call Me Fantastic and of course our beautiful Moor Power mascara to create a really nice smoky look. Now, I'm not gonna use too many products because I wanna keep it as easy and as simple for you guys. I feel like the best way to really do this is to use a contour powder because I could use an eyeshadow palette, but I might as well just show you how to use it with whatever you may just have in your kit. So let's say you have your Conceal and Conquer done, just like me. You have a Hoola bronzer, which I love, and then you have your eyeliner and mascara, and you know what? This will be pretty much good to go. We can totally fake this. Oh, also if you have an eyebrow palette, that would be really great. So I'm gonna use the light and medium from Benefit. This is the Brow Zings palette. Yeah, so let's get started. So right now, all I have on my face is my concealer, my Conceal and Conquer 3-step process. If you've seen my videos previously, I have that. And then I've contoured my face, I've contoured my nose, and that's pretty much it. Like I have a little contour on my eyelids as well. That's pretty much it. So let's get started, shall we? So now we're gonna start with our Call Me Fantastic eyeliner. I've just lined my inner upper waterline. And the reason why we do this is because it actually closes the gap between your mascara. So when you apply your mascara and your lashes, so when you apply mascara and you lift it, sometimes you lift it so much that you see this little gap. And people tend to forget that this is such an important part to do. It's a little bit ticklish and it's uncomfortable, but it makes the biggest difference. I don't know if you can see, but I don't have it on this side. And this side, that's all I've done. I haven't done the bottom line. I've literally done that inner upper waterline and it probably already looks darker. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that on my lower lash line as well, lower waterline. And I'm gonna actually apply it, because we're doing a smoky look today. I'm gonna apply it all the way to the inner part and see, show you how dark that is. Really dark, really, really dark. What I like to do is just clean it out because it's always touching your inner corner, right? Or your waterline. It's just hygienic to clean it all the time. So you can see this is super dark now. Now this is the trick. I'm gonna take my Hoola. Let's say I have nothing in my bag, I have no eyeshadow, I have nothing. I'm gonna take my little Hoola powder and I'm gonna press it into my lid because the brush is quite wide. You don't wanna get it all over. You just wanna press it in like this. And then what I like to do with this is connect it to my nose and continue the contour down, just like that. I've already contoured with my contour stick, but just for the impact of this smoky look, this is what I'm gonna do. Now, I'm gonna take an eyebrow brush. This one's like a nice little angled brush. And I'm gonna apply the same Hoola bronzer just on the outside of where I applied the Call Me Fantastic. So just what that's gonna do is it's gonna blend it so beautifully together that it's gonna give you this nice, soft, smoky look. Now, this is the fun part. This is the trick. Now, this is the foolproof way of doing a smoky eye. Everyone tries, everyone complains about not being able to do it. So this is my little trick. What you are gonna need is two brushes, one more of a fluffy brush and one that's more of a crease brush like this. And of course the eyebrow brush that we've used already. And what I'm gonna, so now that I have that bronzer on, what I'm gonna do it so messy so that you guys, cause a lot of people get really intimidated by a smoky. So I'm gonna do it really messy so you can see. Starting from the outside, I'm gonna apply a liner. It's super fun, just like this, squiggling it over. Not on the inner part, but just lining it up like this. Crazy, right? It's okay, you don't need to have the crazy straight line. If you have, you know, the Anastasia palettes of eyeshadows, they come with these brushes. You can even use that because it's dual-ended. It has a little bit of a sharper one that's great for the crease and a fluffy one. So just so that it's easier for you guys. So just kind of press this liner out. So I'm putting a lot of pressure here and just blending it down towards the lash line and blending it outward. And what this is gonna do is blend that beautiful liner and give you a very nice, foolproof, soft smoky. Now I know what you're thinking, oh no, this is so messy. How am I gonna deal with this? Well, that's why we use the other side to blend it all together with the Hoola bronzer. So see this? I'm smudging and smudging and smudging. Now I'm gonna take the Hoola bronzer with the fluffy side and just apply that over. Now this is one of the tricks I love doing because it's so easy. Just imagine when you don't have time in your day and you need to look good and dress up and look, you know, go for an evening night out. This is your trick. So now with the balance on the other side, that because you've used that to smudge, what you're gonna do is you're gonna actually do that on the lower lash line, just like this. I'm gonna take a little mirror so I can hold it, and I'm gonna just blend whatever. I'm not taking extra product. I'm just gonna take and blend this out. Gonna give me a nice, beautiful smoky. And go into the crease, just like that. And there you go. That is a super easy, literally 3 minute smoky eye, less if you're like quick as me. Well, I'm pretty quick because I'm not bothered. Then I'm gonna go with my eyebrow product because that's really important. So I'm just gonna brush it with a little spoolie, brush it upwards and use the brow product. I like to start on the outer corner over here and bring it down. It is important to do brows. It's very important because if you have gaps that you need to fill, this is probably your best bet to do so, right? And what you can also do is with that brow powder, if you wanna apply a little bit more of the smoky, you can just apply that on the bottom of your eyes. Take a brush, clean it up. Take your warrior sponge and press that like this. So if you've had any fallouts from maybe the bronzer or the eyeliner's just smudged a little, this is your little magic tool that you just press into your skin and wipe out like this. Ta-da! Now I'm gonna go with a little blush because we do have that in our makeup kit. Although you can use your molten matte, just applying that over here. Now if you have your blush and you want a little more color on your smoky, another trick is take a little bit of that blush and just apply that right over where the crease was to give that even more of like a warm touch of smoky. And that'll look really gorgeous. You can even take a little bit of that and apply it on the bottom to soften up the smoky. And this is really one of my favorite tricks to do. I feel like it just like it's so easy. Next thing, mascara. Now this little product right here took me really long again to make because there's a lot of stuff that goes on with product development, and I wanted something super reflective. I wanted something that you could kind of have. In fact, my first prototype had a mirror on it, and then I felt like it kind of made it look tacky. It didn't look as cool as our lipsticks. So then what I decided to do was have this extremely reflective so that it's just this beautiful piece of gold. It is gold. And you can still use it as a mirror because the reflection is so good and the quality is just great. So if I do say so myself. So I'm gonna start by applying our mascara. So now the way that I've created this is that I wanted the end part to be slightly tapered and slightly fluffy, and it tapers in. And what that does is it's really great to lift your lashes on the inner corners as well as the outer. So here's a trick when you're applying mascara. You wanna always look down, right, and go as close to your waterline as possible, your upper lashes. Wiggle it up and lift it. Wiggle it up, lift, wiggle. So I like to do a couple of coats, and I'm gonna just do the center over here because I wanna show you how I use the tapered part. Now, lift your elbows up. This is something I learned in makeup school. It's actually placement of arms is very important. Lift this up so that you don't hit your nose. And if you do, that's okay, because I have a trick for that too. And lift your lashes up on the inner corners, just like this. And that will get even the tiniest little baby lashes to lift. And then the same on the outer. Lift, see, that's because of the little thin part, it's actually able to lift the outer part right there. And then now that that's drying, I'm gonna go into the lower lash line and lift. Now I love lashes, so for me, I go all out with them. You can see that there's a big difference between my left eye and my right eye. Okay, this is good. I made a little boo-boo over here. This is good, so you can see. I'm gonna use my warrior sponge. I'm gonna press it, and I'm gonna just lightly wipe it out. Not too much, but lightly. And if you feel like you have fallout, you can just use a little powder and get that in there. Okay, wait for it to dry a sec, and then again, lift up. This, and our mascara is really buildable, so you can go as, you can just do a light mascara look, or you can go for a full on, like I'm gonna do right now, and go all out. This will really be able to give you this like cat eye look. There you go. The next thing I'm gonna do, I'm only doing one side so you can see. Okay, so what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna use any lip liner. I'm just gonna use a MAC one. I think this is called Spice. And I'm gonna use my More Power as a mirror right now. So I'm gonna apply from the start, the top over here, to create a Cupid's bow because I feel like I don't have much of a lip. So I'm gonna create like a beautiful Cupid's bow over here with a liner. And I want to obviously lift my lips up. Well, not obviously, not everyone likes this, I do. Drawing a line in the center because I like it a little fluffier. Now I'm gonna take my Molten Matte in the shade Hustler because I feel like a little bit of a hustler today. And because also with the Smokey Eye, it just looks really good. It's like the perfect brown. I'm just gonna continue where I was and just apply that. What do you guys think of this shade? I personally love Hustler. It's one of my go-tos and it really makes me feel so powerful. I love this. So now you can see I've done one side of my face. Couldn't really do just one side of my face, obviously, with the lip. But if you can just imagine, this side just looks a lot more lifted. It looks more smoky. It's a different look and it's super easy to do. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side just so you guys can see. Hope you guys like that. It's super easy actually. I think a lot of people get intimidated by the smoky eye. I know a lot of people, they'll be like, no, I can't do a smoky eye. I look like a raccoon. That is the number one thing that I get told all the time. And I think it's very important to know that there are ways to do it and there are little tricks. And I'm here to teach you all these little techniques. I'm also here to create products to make it easy for you to blend. So we have our sponge that is the Warrior Sponge. We have the Call Me Fantastic, which the eyeliner is super dark, but it's also really, really good to blend into your skin and it doesn't look patchy. And of course, our More Power Mascara, which really is pretty self-explanatory. It is everything powerful that you need in your face. Lashes just make the biggest difference. And yeah, I really think that this is an easy 3-minute smoky eye. It's foolproof because you don't need to do any straight lines. There's not much you can really mess up while doing this. And I just hope that you guys learn a lot from these little YouTube videos that I'm doing now. And if there's anything at all that you need, or if you want to, you know, if you have suggestions, or if you even have tips for me, please give them to me because I'm so new here. I would love to know what tips I could do with anything, lighting, background, face, makeup, techniques, angles, anything. Our products are all available on Sephora in Southeast Asia, Singapore, Malaysia, Philippines, Hong Kong. They're also available for the US in Amazon, so amazon.com, macys.com, natashamoor.com, and ShopHQ as well. We are also going to be launching globally, and I'm super duper excited to be able to have our products given to you. I'm so excited for you guys to actually try these products because I've made them with so much of my heart and soul that I can't wait for you guys to all try them.